I'm Malcolm Gladwell, host of the podcast Smart Talks with IBM. Recently, I traveled to Kennesaw State University to explore a groundbreaking question. Can AI revolutionize the way we teach math and reasoning? At Kennesaw State University, professors are using IBM's WatsonX platform to develop AI assistants for teacher training. Unlike typical AI chatbots, these AI assistants are designed to help teachers in training practice responsive teaching in simulated environments, providing a more interactive and educational experience.
I sat down with Davi Lee, a professor specializing in AI and education, and Sean English, a researcher who collaborates with her to develop these AI assistants, to learn how they work. Let's go into the journey of building this thing. You started WA by taking a course. What was the course you took?
Yeah, so it was offered by Coursera. It was designed by IBM. It was AI Foundation for Everyone.
Mm-hmm. Oh, how long did that course take how long to take?
It was not too long. It was like 14 weeks.
Dobby's idea was to use IBM's WatsonX portfolio to build an AI assistant that was trained on data to play the role of the student, a digital persona of a 9-year-old who likes math but doesn't always understand math. And that AI assistant, she thought, could be used to train pre-service teachers or teachers in training who are preparing to enter one of the most challenging professions in the modern world.
So when you think about the teacher education, and a major challenge that teacher education face is that we need children to practice with, we need instructors who will give the instruction on the pedagogical skills, and we need the pre-service teachers. And so when you look at the teacher education program, we have coursework and field experience. And in those two areas, there is something missing all the time. So what we try to resolve is that we have this virtual student for pre-service teacher to work with so that they can practice their responsive teaching skills.
The first AI assistant Lee created is Jiwoo. Jiwoo emulates the persona of a 9-year-old third grade girl. Then, with the help of one of her collaborators, a researcher at Kennesaw named Sean English, she created two more AI assistants, Gabriel and Noah, each of which have their own distinctive learning style. So how are Gabriel and Noah different from Jiwoo?
So for example, Gabriel, my first one, he's very short answered. If you ask an open-ended question, he will answer it in a closed way. So I use that characteristic, and that's the problem that most teachers actually face. There are children who are shy, who are reserved, and who not share much of their thoughts. So we wanted that characteristic in some characters, and we used Gabriel to have that characteristic. Mm-hmm.
And Noah, what's Noah's personality?
Happy, playful, cheery, yeah. Bright, energetic.
You know. And Jiwoo?
Jiwoo is articulative and kind of smart. But she has her own way of thinking.
Martin was making Play-Doh. He added 3/4 cup of flour to the bowl. Then he added another 3/6 cup. Is the total amount of flour he used greater than or less than 1 cup? How much flour did he use?
Pause it for a second. So Jiwoo is trying to solve this problem.
Mm-hmm.
And the first thing she does is she draws a rectangle on the screen, mm-hmm. and she divides it into 4 pieces. Mm-hmm. And now she's gonna color in 3 of the 4 pieces.
Yes.
She's representing, this is quite good. Mm-hmm. She's representing 3/4 on the screen, okay?
And this is 3/6.
So now Jiwoo does another rectangle with 6 boxes and colors in 3 of them. Okay.
Then when you add them together, that makes 6 out of 10.
Then she counts up all the colored boxes, mm-hmm. and that's her numerator, mm-hmm. and counts up the total number of boxes, and that's her denominator. Yeah. Jiwoo had counted the colored boxes and landed on an answer. When you add 3/4 cup and 3/6 cup, you get 6/10 cup. So, according to Jiwoo, Martin has less than 1 cup.
And she thinks she solved the problem.
Yes.
So the question is, what do I, yeah. as a teacher, say to Jiwoo?
So Jiwoo says the blue and red pieces are not the same sizes. Oh.
So you understand now Jiwoo knows the size differences.
So she's pretty smart here.
Yeah.
After testing my responsive teaching skills, I traveled back to New York City, where I spoke to IBM's Brian Bissell, who helps IBM customers discover how best to get AI to work for them. Bissell made the point that we're well past the stage where anyone wonders whether AI can be useful. The real question now is, what problems do we want it to solve? Where can it make the biggest difference? And for Bissell, one of the fields with the biggest opportunities was education.
I have 2 kids, one in middle school and one who just graduated high school. And I'm well aware of students using things like ChatGPT to do their homework. And it's very easy to take tools like that and even IBM's own large language models and just take a problem, a piece of homework, something you want written, and drop it into that and have it generate the answer for you. And the student, the user in that case, hasn't done any work. They haven't put any real thought into it. Instead of providing the answer, it gives you a way forward and a way to prompt the student to learn the material better. And so how can we do that?
As Brian points out, the real opportunity isn't just about getting answers faster. It's about helping students truly engage with the material. Instead of simply providing solutions, the goal is to guide deeper learning. Let's take a closer look at how Jiwoo is designed to do just that. Jiwoo says, I have learned that I could add any numbers in grade 2. So 3+3 is 6 and 4+6 is 10.
Yeah, so she is using the knowledge of adding integers into adding fractions.
Now I'm stumped. So now I have to somehow lead her to figure out a way to get her to understand that we're dealing with a different kind of problem. Mm-hmm. All right? And that a harder problem. I'm confused. Oh no, I've confused poor Jiwoo.
But it's good. She's understanding. She's realizing her misconception. So she's getting confused.
She says, I'm confused. 3/4 is pretty close to 1. And adding 3/6 would make it go over 1. Oh, so she's got the answer.
Yeah.
But then she says, but there are 6 pieces out of 10, which is less than 1. So I don't get it.
She's the point that, I have something wrong here. So there is a cognitive dissonance. She realized that. That's a good sign.
She's getting there.
Yeah, she's getting there.
One of the rollouts of Jiwoo, Gabriel, and Noah was with the teacher training program at the University of Missouri.
I was just kind of excited to see what the program was and what it was going to be doing.
This is Logan Hovis, a junior at Missouri on the path to becoming an elementary school teacher.
Obviously a little skeptical when he said it was supposed to, be like talking to a student. You're like, there's no way this AI thing is going to totally sound like a second grader or a third grader. Like, it's going to sound like an adult, or it's going to sound like a robot that knows all the answers. And it really didn't. It really was like talking to a child. It was very, very well developed in the way that you really sit there and you feel like you're talking to a kid.
Her point wasn't that Jiwoo and her fellow avatars were equivalent to real kids. Of course not. But for someone starting out, someone who was already nervous about being plunged into a classroom of 9-year-olds, Jiwoo was like the warm-up before the baseball game.
What I can think of is like, how when you're at batting practice for baseball or softball, you have those automatic pitchers that throw them because you're working on your skill as the hitter. What can I do differently? What am I doing wrong? But that doesn't replace the game and what you do in a game, but this is you getting to practice your own skills to be better when you go in a game. And I think that's kind of what the AI software feels like for us.
We often think of AI as a tool for speeding things up, but we shouldn't forget that it also allows for us to slow things down. While a real 9-year-old might get bored quickly, AI like Jiwoo can patiently help teachers in training practice responsive teaching for as long as needed. The journey of developing AI assistants for teacher training is just beginning, but the potential impact on education is profound. IBM's What's Next platform is enabling educators to create personalized and effective learning experiences, transforming teacher training and enhancing education.
To dive deeper into this fascinating topic and hear more about the innovative work at Kennesaw State University, listen to the full episode of Smart Talks with IBM. You can find it wherever you get your podcasts.